Hi everyone, I've never done an exclusive video before on my butternut squash, and I'm really excited to bring it to you today. You might have seen me mention it in other videos, or I've posted pictures on Instagram, but this is one of those plants I'm really excited about, has held up to all the issues we've been dealing with this summer, and we are going to be posting a video about that later because it's been a tough summer for us out here in the garden, and we'll tell you more about that in a future video. But this plant has been amazing. It has grown like crazy. I was super excited to plant it, and honestly, I haven't done anything except water it. My plan was originally to plant some seeds here on the very end of my garden bed where I have my vertical trellis, and then grow it out along some empty space I had right in this spot ahead of me. But it had a mind of its own, started growing up the trellis, and it's a good thing because I just love how this looks just hanging down here on the trellis. That's one of the reasons I wanted this trellis, is to see the fruit and the vegetables hanging down. But the exciting thing today is I've got one that is ready to harvest. And this plant is amazing because it has squash at various different stages. There's one ready to harvest. There's some that'll be ready in a couple of weeks. There's some that are just coming on. So I can tell this plant will be producing for me for months to come, which is exactly what you want. But now let's get to the exciting part, the harvest part. Well, it's super exciting to see that I've got three butternut squash that are almost ready to harvest. And upon closer examination, I don't think they're quite ready, so we may not be picking them today, but let me show you what I look for. You can see the one that's hanging down right here is that light green color. When they get close to harvest, they turn a tan color, like this one I have right here. Now, this is the one that you might have seen in the hand pollinating video. I did hand pollinate this, was really excited that it has grown to full size. You can see it's turned a nice light tan color. It still does have these green stripes here, which tells me it might not quite be ready. I'd like to see more of a deeper tan. So the first thing I look for is the color. The second thing I look for is the stem. And you can see the stem here is starting to shrivel up, which is a good sign. I'd like it to be a little more brown before I harvest it, because that's a sign that the squash is done growing and it's getting close to harvest time. So first the color, second the stem, third is the toughness of the skin. And a really good test is to take the squash and try and puncture it with your thumb. And this one, I'm getting some resistance, but I can still puncture it, which tells me it may need a little bit more time to ripen on the vine, because once you pick it, it doesn't ripen anymore, so you want to make sure that it's ready. The key is, though, if you wait too long, then it gets mushy. So I'm going to be keeping an eye on this one right here, and I have a couple more down that are growing right along the trellis, one here that's growing down along the ground that are just about ready, and hopefully we'll have a harvest video for you that in just a couple of weeks. Well, I can tell I have so much butternut squash coming on this vine. I'm gonna be having a harvest for a couple of months yet. I'm gonna have a bumper crop this year, which I'm really excited about. Let me know if you're growing butternut squash and some recipe ideas. I have a couple tried and true that I like to go to, but I'm always looking for new ideas. And one thing I love about butternut squash is it stores extremely well. I know I had one last year sitting on my counter for about 6 weeks before I used it. I know it can store for several months. So thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.